In this video, I'll show you 20 ways to select in Blender. We'll start with the basics, but by the end, I bet there's a few ways to select objects or geometry that you didn't know about. Some of these are for edit mode, some are for object mode, and many are for both, so let's go. Number one, basic selection. Basic selection in Blender's object mode is by default done by left-clicking. Left-click this object to select it, left-click that object, etc. In edit mode, it works the same way, but we always have three selection modes: vertex select, edge select, and face select. We can change between them using these icons or with the shortcuts 1, 2, and 3 on the keyboard. That's the top of the keyboard, not on the number pad. In either mode, to select multiple elements or objects, we hold shift and keep left clicking so the previous object does not become deselected. To unselect everything, we can click off into open 3D space like this, or press Alt-A on the keyboard to deselect everything in Blender. Also, with multiple objects selected, we can hold shift and left click an object again to deselect individual objects. The object may need to be clicked twice depending on whether it's the active object or not. This works the same way when selecting in edit mode. Oh, and by the way, the scene I'm using to demo in this video was provided by 3D Shaker. This is one of hundreds of high quality scenes like these they have available on Blender Market. Take a look at their stuff with the link in the description. Number two, select all. To select everything that is visible in a scene, press A on the keyboard. This will work in object mode or edit mode. It will not select objects that we have hidden using the keyboard shortcut H. So if there are things you don't want to select, consider hiding them first. Number three, box select. Box select allows us to left click and drag our cursor to create a box in the 3D viewport. Whatever is inside the box will be selected. It works in both object mode and edit mode. To choose box select, we can left click and hold this selection button in the toolbar. If we don't see the toolbar, press T on the keyboard to open it up. Choose select box, or we can use the keyboard shortcut B to enter box select mode. Again, we left click and drag to select. Number four, circle select. Circle select turns our cursor into a circle. We left click and drag the cursor, and anything we drag over will be selected. It works in object mode and in edit mode. To access it, left click and hold the select tool in the toolbar and choose select circle. Or we can press C on our keyboard to enter circle select mode. Number five, lasso select. If you've used Photoshop or other programs, you probably know the term lasso. We can left click and hold the selection tool in the toolbar and choose select lasso. To my knowledge, there is no keyboard shortcut for this. In edit mode or object mode, we left click and drag to draw a shape which will close itself when we release the left mouse button. Anything in that shape will become selected. Number six, select loops and rings. Loops and rings, I guess they're two different things, but they can be selected the same way. This is an edit mode only selection tool. Let's say I want to select an entire ring of faces on this sphere. In face select mode, I can hover right over the line between two faces and hold the Alt key while I left click. It will select the entire ring or loop or whatever this thing is called. In edge select mode, it worked the same way. We can hover over an edge and it'll select the loop of edges as far as it can go. In vertex select mode, it'll do the same thing. That's Alt left click to select loops and rings. Number seven, select shortest path. This is another of Blender's edit mode only selection tools. We can left click an element in vertex, edge, or face select modes, and then hold down Control or Command on a Mac and click another element somewhere else. As long as the two are part of the same connected geometry, Blender will select the shortest path between the two and everything in between them. That's Control left click to select the shortest path. Number eight, select more or less. If we have a selection in edit mode, we can increase or decrease the selection. Hold Control on the keyboard and press either the plus or minus sign on the number pad. Control plus will add to the selection. Control minus will shrink the selection. Number nine, invert selection. In both object mode and edit mode, we can invert our selection by pressing Control I. When we do this, whatever isn't selected will become selected, and whatever was selected will become unselected. It again will not affect anything that has been hidden using H. Again, the Blender keyboard shortcut to invert a selection is Control-I. Number 10, select all by type. I think this is where we enter some more advanced selection methods for Blender users. By the way, hitting the like button on this video would mean a whole lot to me. Thank you so much. And I have a full guide that kind of accompanies this video at my website, brandonsdrawings.com. We already covered how to select everything by pressing A on the keyboard. But in object mode, that will select cameras, lights, and literally everything in the scene. We may just want to select all of the mesh objects or just the lights or something like that. We can select all objects by object type in Blender by going to the Select menu at the top of the 3D viewport. Choose Select All by Type and choose from the list of object types. If we select Mesh, all mesh objects and only mesh objects will be selected. I should point this out now, and this will be true for many of these selection options. After we make the selection, an operator panel will open in the bottom left corner of the 3D viewport. Expand it to see options specific to our last selection. By default, selecting all by type will deselect what we previously had selected. To demonstrate, I have all of the mesh objects selected right here. If I go to select all by type and choose lights, the lights become selected, but the mesh objects become deselected. In the operator panel, we can choose extend, and this means the new selection will be added to the old selection instead of replacing it. Number 11, select random. The next selection tool is select random, which does what it sounds like it does. It will work in edit mode and object mode and will randomly select from whatever we have in our scene that's not hidden. So in object mode, it will randomly select objects regardless of their type. In edit mode, it will randomly select vertices, edges, or faces depending on our selection mode. Go to the select menu and choose select random. We get a random selection that by default is 50% of whatever is available to select. Open the operator panel in the bottom left corner of the viewport. We can increase or decrease the ratio of selected to unselected elements. And we can choose a different randomization by changing the random seed value. Number 12, checker deselect. This one is technically a deselection tool, but I think it still belongs on the list. In edit mode, we start with an area selected and go to select, checker deselect. By default, it will create a perfect checker pattern out of our selection. In the operator panel at the bottom left of the viewport, we can adjust how many consecutively selected and deselected elements of the mesh we want. And we can offset the checker pattern. It's easy to visualize this on a cube, but I use it a lot on cylinders too. It's a huge time saver. Number 13, select linked. Lucky number 13 for our Blender selection tutorial is select linked. This is also an edit mode selection tool. With one area of a mesh selected, we hover over that area with our cursor and press L on the keyboard. It will select all geometry linked to whatever we are hovering over. There are different limits we can choose for whatever is considered to be linked. In the operator panel, the default is seam, I believe. But if we selected material or UV or any of these other options, the selection will stop when it reaches the end of whatever we have selected. Here's an example where I'll use it to select all the linked parts of a mesh with the same material. I use this so much I actually programmed it into one of the programmable buttons on my favorite Logitech mouse. I love this mouse, and we'll link to it in the description if you want to check it out. 14, select similar. Here's something almost everyone can find useful in Blender. It's called select similar and works in edit mode. Let's say we have this window selected on this building and we want to select all the other windows. We can access select similar by going to the select menu and choosing the select similar option. Then we have these options, or we can use the keyboard shortcut shift G and this menu will come up. I'll select the window pane and then choose select similar and coplanar. All the windows on this side of the building are coplanar, meaning they're on the same plane so they get selected. We can also select all faces with the same area, perimeter, or number of sides. You can see there are several options here to select mesh that share characteristics with the current selection. Number 15, select all by trait. Select all by trait might sound a lot like select similar, but it's different. In edit mode, go to select and choose select all by trait. Then we can choose from a few options. These options will change depending on whether we are in vertex, edge, or face select mode, and we don't actually need anything selected before we use this. Loose geometry will select geometry that is not connected to the rest of the object. The faces by sides section is useful. Use it, and then in the operator panel, enter a number of sides for the selection of faces. Then choose to select what is not equal to, greater than, equal to, or less than this number of sides. If we were trying to identify all the ingons in our mesh, we could select anything with greater than four sides. Pretty handy. There are a few other options you can play around with. Number 16, select mirror. Select mirror functions differently in edit mode than it does in object mode, but technically works in both. In edit mode, it will mirror the selection across an axis. In the operator panel, we tell it which axis to mirror, or mirror multiple axes by holding shift as we click on the X, Y, and Z buttons. Again, by default, it will deselect the original selection, but we can check extend to have the new selection added to the original. In object mode, select mirror, we'll use the naming convention of objects to select the mirror. This is a little more advanced, but in a character model, if we had an object named hand.left and one named hand.right, this will select the mirrored object as long as we have their names set up correctly. 17, select side of active. In Blender's edit mode, we can use the Side of Active Selection tool to select everything that is on one side, that's left, right, top, bottom, etc., of the actively selected mesh element. In the operator panel, we choose the axis to select across. This requires an active vertex to be used as a reference point. Here's an example. I have this object and I select this vertex. I want to select everything on this side of that vertex. Go to Select, Side of Active. In the operator panel, we can choose which side of which axis, or choose Aligned Axis, and Blender will select everything that is perfectly aligned along that axis. Number 18, Select Pattern. The Select Pattern tool lets us select based on the names of objects in object mode. Go to Select and choose Select Pattern. A dialog box will open. We basically search for objects by name, but can use wildcard search terms. A question mark is a wildcard for a single character, and an asterisk is for multiple characters. So if we have a bunch of objects named cube 1, cube 2, etc., type in cube asterisk, and it will select all of them. Number 19, select by material. When we are in edit mode, we can select mesh which has specific materials applied to it. In this example, there are multiple materials assigned to this object. Nothing is selected. We choose the material we want to select in the material properties panel, then choose select underneath it. Now all parts of the mesh with that material assigned are selected. We can also deselect with this method. Let's say all of the mesh was selected. We can deselect geometry with this material assigned to it. And number 20 is select by vertex group. In Blender, we can create vertex groups and then add specific vertices to those groups. These can later be used for a lot of things, but also as a selection tool. Vertex groups are added, edited, and selected in the Object Data Properties panel. First, create a vertex group, then select vertices and press Assign to add the selected vertices to the group. Then, later, we can use the Select and Deselect buttons underneath for the selected vertex group. My name is Brandon. Have a look around the channel. Please give the video a like, and I'd love to have you as a subscriber. Throw some support to the links in the description, and as always, stay creative.